Good evening and welcome to In Country. Armed Forces Television Vietnam presents In Country, a variety program about people, places, and things occurring in country. Your host, Army Specialist John Steinbeck.
Good evening and welcome to In Country. This evening we have with us the Assistant Director of Light Entertainment for the Australian Broadcasting Commission, its dance band in Sydney, and three girls which I personally saw destroy the composure of the 1st Infantry Division at Zion and the Republic of Korean Army. On my right is Mr. Bruce Weber, who wears that long title from the Australian Broadcasting Commission. Good evening. How are you, Bruce?
Hello, John, and thanks very much indeed for the invitation to come in here tonight.
I ran into Mr. Weber and this group of entertainers in Zion following a field trip that they were on for the past how many days now?
We've been on the road now almost a fortnight.
It must be exhausting.
Well, it is, but it's a wonderfully thrilling experience, you know. We came out here to play, well, first of all, to Australians. We played the Australian bases, the battalions in the south, the field hospital in the south. And in this past week, we've just had a wonderful time coming down from Da Nang and working our way down through the USO circulating people.
Yes. This kind of demands a difference in material, doesn't it, performing for Australians and Americans?
Surprisingly little. Just one or two references, which were purely locally Australian. Well, we had to drop those, but musically, it's absolutely the same.
It's a magnificent sound that they do get. The dance band is certainly one of the most reputable that I've ever heard. Who did the arrangements for these pieces?
Well, we have a staff of three arrangers, but this show was put together as a completely fresh show for this occasion. And it was only done at about a month's notice, so we had to employ more. In fact, there were half a dozen arrangers working on this show for the month before we came away.
This opening number that we're about to hear now, I understand, is an original Australian tune.
It's an original Australian tune. It's called I've Been Everywhere, and it's got American words, it's got English words, and it's got Australian words. But you're not going to hear any, because we open our show with it purely instrumental, and this is the band's intro to today's show as well.
And we're going to open this one.
Hello there, my name is is the reindeer. Your lunch in a 21, they're watching your diet set. Declining your solid foods, accepting a finger. When out of the clear blue sky, it's suddenly gal and guy. And this could be the start of something bigger. There's no controlling the unrolling of your fate, my friend. Who knows what's written in the magic book? When a lover you discover at the gate, my friend, and you invite him in without a second look, you're off in a caribou, a tiny sardine, or lying at Malibu, alone on the sand. You suddenly hear a bell, and right away you can tell that this could be the start of something. This could be the hottest something. This could be the start of something.
I quit. I'm moving on. Thank you.
Give you an idea of just what the ABC group does, I would say you are probably either blind, deaf, or plainly subversive. Immediately on my left now is Miss Laurie Desmond, who opens and closes the show with quite a bang. All right, good evening. It's good to have you on the show.
Good to be here, Jeff.
I'd like to know, because I understand you are a stage actress as well as an entertainer, just what you're doing in Vietnam.
Well, it's quite simple, really, Joe. They rang in, said that I'd come up here, and I couldn't think of anything I would love to, but I'm just a ignorant hit man.
The response from the troops, I noticed out at Zion, where I visited the group the other day when they were performing for the 1st Infantry Division, was extremely appreciative of their performance. And one thing that amazed me was the fact that the Koreans, people that don't necessarily understand our entertainment form, were very appreciative of the act.
Well, I think music is universal. Languages don't matter when it comes to music.
I've got to agree, and I think that the decor of you and your associates over there had a good deal to do with the appreciation as well. What are your future plans for work in Australia when you get back from Vietnam?
Well, I imagine I'll do some television, radio, club work, and I hope another play.
Is there a good deal of theater in Australia?
Yes, as a matter of fact, it's quite interesting, and there's an American by the name of Hayes Gordon who's helping a great deal with drama in Australia.
Very good. Our overseas Nijinsky now, Miss Jackie DePaul. Jackie, I understand you worked for a great long time at the Palladium in London, which in her words and many others is the greatest theater in the world. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yes, I was there for 3 years. I worked at the Palladium. First year I was one of the chorus. The second year I was taken out and made principal dancer, which was wonderful. And I worked with many famous people, film stars and theater stars, which is a great difference. And being in England and working there was the greatest thing that ever happened to me. I thought till I came to Vietnam.
Can I ask you where you buy your jungle fatigues?
I can't, I don't know.
Miss Dinah Lee, who is on Jackie DePaul's left, is, I understand, the top rock and roll singer in Australia. She has 3 number one records to her credit, and she's certainly wrapping up a good deal more in Vietnam. Dinah, I understand this is your second tour here.
That's right, John, I was over here last June to entertain, but of course we weren't here as long last year, and we entertained Australians and only about 2 or 3 lots of Americans, but this year we entertained lots more. I thoroughly enjoyed it.
You've done a good deal of American television as well, haven't you?
That's right, I was over in America in 1965, and I did Shindig and Hollywood Go-Go.
What's Australian rock and roll doing, since you seem to do principally rock and roll in this show? The English advent of rock and roll hit the United States with such a storm. Do you have many artists now in Australia that are singing rock music?
Yes, we have lots of artists over there, and just as good, in fact, I think, as what they are in America and England.
Since this is your second time over here, could you give me an idea of your impressions of Vietnam?
I find it very exciting to do this, but it has changed a little bit since I was here last year.
Lori, you've worked a good deal with top American stars. Ms. Bruce has already told me that you're on the Jack Benny Show and the Dean Martin Show.
No, not Dean Martin. Jack Benny, Steve Allen, and Ernie Ford. That was the Ernie Ford Show. And I did a lot of television in England with Terry Thomas, who I was known
as. Magnificent to me. I wish I knew his status. Tell me one more thing that fascinates me. Since all of you people have been working for the Australian Broadcasting Commission at one time or another, did they, Bruce, did they have anything to do with organizing this thing, or was this entirely your effort?
No, the ABC cooperates with the Australian Army in sending entertainment up here. This is our largest effort to date. We sent a number of parties of 6 and 8, but this was the first time we managed to bring 18 people.
18 entire people, and the Army, their Army personnel over here are helping you logistically, getting
they are, and they're supplying us with a great deal of assistance, and they travel with us up through the American zones as well.
Where have you been?
Well, we began down in the south with the Australian battalions at Nui Dak. We played for the RAAF, the Royal Australian Air Force, at Phong Tao, and certain other base personnel, and then we got into the American circuit, and we played at Da Nang. Unfortunately, we didn't play for the Marines. The plane was late, and we had to cancel a concert. We came down to Taekyu, and we played several days, 3 I think it was, in Taekyu altogether. And we finished up, as you saw it, out of Xi'an. Now we're back in Saigon, and just about to wind up our tour.
Well, I want to thank you all for appearing on our show here in country. And I want to add in the credit section that the applause you heard during the numbers were compliments of several 100,000 soldiers that have been reported following an Australian bus through Vietnam. Good night, Ms. Desmond, Mr. Paul, and Ms. Lee. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
In Country with Army Specialist John Steinbeck has been a variety feature presentation of Armed Forces Television, Vietnam.